Here are two ways to create an email list in Gmail. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and this video will show you how to create an email list in Gmail. When it comes to creating mailing lists in Gmail, you're going to do so in one of two ways, either by creating lists or creating groups. So then, as an example, instead of typing out each individual email address, you can simply type in the name of the group or label or mailing list that you want to send the email to. The first way to create an email list in Gmail is via your Google contacts by creating a label, believe it or not. And this works for both free and paid accounts. From Gmail, head on up to the Google Apps icon near the top right and click on Contacts. Now, if you haven't used Contacts before, you've got the option of creating a contact or importing contacts. Obviously, for this method, you're going to want to add your contacts here, which you can add contacts directly from Gmail as well. All you have to do is hover over the sender info in Gmail and then click on the Add to Contacts icon. Okay, heading back to contacts. I don't want to dox anyone, so I'm going to set this up here with some examples for you. So let's say I want these three recipients to be in the same mailing list. I'm going to select all of them and head to the labels icon near the top and create a label. I'm going to call this Google Course Group, and I'm going to click on Save. And just like that, I've created this Google Course Group where if I hover over, I can edit the name and who's in the group or delete the label. So now that this label with these contacts has been created, back in Gmail, when I compose an email, I no longer have to type each address out individually. I can simply start typing Google Course Group. And here is the label I've created, and it shows me how many members there are in this label. I'll click on that, and instantly, all members are added to the To field. Remember though, if you add this to the To field, everyone on that email list will see each other's email addresses. So to fix this, all you have to do is instead add that label you created to the BCC field in your compose window. Now, with those emails hidden, the recipients won't be able to see the other email addresses of all those other recipients. Remember this step if it's important to you. And by the way, this is just one small Google tip in a sea of Google tips and tricks. And I've mastered so much of Google over the years that I have created a custom Google course just for you. So I've got a link to my Everything Google, Mastering Your Google Suite of Apps course listed for you in the description below should you want even more hands-on learning. So that's one very easy way to create an email list in Gmail. But as I mentioned, there is a second way. We're going to do that by creating a group via Google Groups. Now you can access Google Groups as a free user or as a paid Google Workspace user. For paid Google Workspace users, Google Groups needs to be activated via the admin console. So if you head to your Google Apps icon and you don't see the Groups option, your organization either may not want you using it, or you may have to have the tech admin toggle it on for you. Or if you are on a free account and you don't see the option in your Google Apps, no worries. All you have to do is simply head to groups.google.com. and you will be brought right to your Groups page. Groups are a great way to communicate and collaborate. So if you want to invite a group to an event or share a document with a group, you can send a single email to everyone in that group. Click on Create Group in the top left, and here you're going to enter in a group name. So following my last example, I'm going to create a Google School Course Group. And as I type in the group name, it populates the group email. So sometimes the email might be taken already, since we're essentially creating an email here. So you can add to this group email name if you need to in order to create a unique group email. Then in the description, I'm going to write a line on what this group is for. So now you have to choose the privacy settings. First, you can decide who can search for this group. So is it anyone, meaning is this a public group or is it group members only? I'm going to select group members only. I do not want this available to anyone on the web. Next, who can join the group? Only invited users, anyone can ask, or anyone can join. I'll select only invited users. Next, you can decide who can view conversations between anyone on the web, group members, group managers, and group owners. I'm going to leave this set to group members. Then select who can post. You can change this after, by the way, if you're not really sure yet. So I'm going to hit next. Here, you can add group members, and there are a couple of ways to do this. You can add group members and send an invite message, or you can toggle on directly add members. It's your preference here. So for this example, I'm gonna send invites. So I'll add the emails of those I want to invite to the group. And then I'm gonna click on create group. I'll select this CAPTCHA because despite rumors, I am not a robot. And I'll hit create group again. And once your group is created, you can add or edit members at any time. So on the left side of the groups page, you're gonna see any groups you've created. You can click on members to see all members in that group. If you want to add, you're gonna click on add members near the top. If you toggle on a specific member, you can remove the member at any time or ban the member. You can also change the role of the member here as well. So now that we've created this group, how do we actually send emails to this list? A couple of ways. Once you click on a group, you can click on New Conversation in the top left. Here, you'll notice a pop-out in the bottom right of your screen that is exactly as you'd see in Gmail. Sending messages from here will post a message in this group. So let's see, once I send this, if I click on Conversations on the left, I can see the message right here. You can reply to messages here and the like. But because this is how to create an email list in Gmail, heading back to Gmail, I've also received an email since I added this address to the group. I can unsubscribe from here or, of course, reply as well. But to actually send to this email list directly from Gmail, I can click the drop-down arrow by the group info and I'll simply copy this group email address that we've created. Now I'm going to compose an email in Gmail and I'm just going to paste that group email address into the to field. I'll write a little test email here and include some random information. And then I'm going to hit send. And now that email has been sent to everyone in that group. Would you look at that? So those are two ways to create an email list in Gmail. If you want even more Google goodness, remember, I have an entire course for you that is basically like going to Google school, where you're going to learn how to master your Google suite of apps. So I have linked to that course for you in the description below, and promo pricing isn't gonna last very long. So run, don't walk. So now I want to hear from you. Did you find this tutorial helpful? If so, let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more content just like this. Thanks for watching. See you next time.